Now we have to make some changes in the program.cs class. What changes? We have to add a new web host builder and we have to configure the startup class. Once we are done with the program class, then we have to focus on the startup class, and in the startup class we need to add the routing and we need to set the default route. At this point, if you are having some issue with any of the concepts, then do not worry. We will cover all these concepts in detail in upcoming videos. But for now, just focus the steps of converting the console application into a web API project. So before adding a new web host builder, first we need to understand what exactly is the host builder. Host builder in ASP.NET Core is a very important concept. Let's see what it is. A host builder is an object and it is used to add some features in the application. Remember, in our console application, we have made some changes in the CSPROS file. And by making some changes, we can see the format of this application has been updated completely. But even after making the changes in the CSPROS file, this is not completely converted to a web application. Here, we need to add some host builder. And to add the host builder, we need to use some methods. The first method is create default builder. This create default builder method is available in host class. So we will use the host class and then we will call this create default builder. If we will use this create default builder method, then let's see what feature we will get in our application. By using this create default builder, we will get the dependency injections by default. This is a very popular concept and it is used in almost all the modern applications. Then we will get a feature of configurations. Configurations are basically the settings that we write in appsettings.json or appsettings.environment-based-application, user secret, environment variables, etc. This create default builder method will provide some facility to read the settings, these configuration settings from these places. Along with these, this will also provide a feature for logging. Remember, logging is a must-have feature in any kind of application. So by using the create default builder, we also get the support of logging. And at the last, it set the content root path to the result of getCurrentDirectory method. This getCurrentDirectory method is available in system.io namespace. And this is very useful to run your application for a specific directory. It means if you are using this create default builder method in our application, then we will get all these functionalities by default in our application. We do not need to add any other third-party library to access these facilities. Let's add this create default builder in this console application. To deal with the host builder, we need to make some changes in the program.cs class. And at this place, we need to add a new method. Let's resolve the namespace. Inside this method, we need to call the create default builder method. So we can use the host class. This host class is available in this microsoft.extensions.hosting namespace. And once we will press the dot, we will see this method create default builder. Let's right click on this method and choose go to definition. At this place, you can see this method is available in this host class. This is again a static class, so we can call this method by using the name of this class. And here we have some definitions. This method is used to initialize a new instance of this host builder class with some pre-configured default. What pre-configured defaults? All the settings that we have just discussed in the previous slide, like the logging, hosting, environment, configurations, etc.